gonna do the last part of the bread.
Excellent, Innis. Well done. Right, so we've proved the bread up. We've done it three times, knocked it back, proved it up again, knocked it back, folded it. Done all that three times. We've now got to a stage where, I don't know if you can see that, it's proved up nicely. It's a little bit tacky, but it's just that it's just exactly how we need it. So when we were folding the dough, you remember, Innis, we had the water in the hands to stop it sticking. This time we need a lot of flour because we're going to dry the top out and put it in our proving basket. So rather than water this time, we need a lot of flour, which is always good. So we're going to put some in our proving basket all the way around. Don't be shy of this. All the way around, rub it in a little bit, get it right into the grooves and the cracks, all the way around, and that's just what you need. Don't ever wash one of these baskets, just let it keep it dry the whole time. Let me just get my plastic spatula. There it's gone, here we go. So, take the dough out, okay? Now it's nicely rounded on the top, we want to keep that and just scoop it out. Okay, so you've got the nice rounded bit on the top. Nice, isn't it?
Yeah.
Turn it upside down, okay? I'm just gonna get a little flour underneath this time, okay? So, what we wanna do is keep that round, turn it over, and that's your presentation side, if you like, okay? Nice little bit of flour. You can see all the air bubbles coming out there. That's what you want, okay? So that means that you've proved it up, knocked about, proved it up, knocked about, and you've got all these lovely bubbles inside. So you want to keep that, so you don't want to be too rough with it, because that's exactly what you're looking for. So you have the flour in your basket.
You don't want
to pop the bubbles, no. Nice bit of flour over the top. You've got flour in your basket. You've got flour on the bench. And what you want to do is just lift it up, and we're going to turn it upside down and put that nice presentation flour side on the inside of the basket, okay? So just like so, in, okay, and just set it nicely. You don't want to move it around too much. Let it set in there, and then we're going to put the cling film over the top just to keep it nice and moist so it doesn't dry out, okay? And then what we're going to do is we're just going to prove that up overnight tonight, okay? So that'll just sit in the windowsill. Sit there quite happily, try and get the cling film all the way around so it doesn't flap off and dry out. And that's it, really. So tomorrow morning, the dough will be proved up nicely, and we'll show you baking it in the oven. Is that okay? Just say goodnight.
Goodnight.
Okay. Happy Easter. Hello, Granny Gramsci. Happy Easter. Right, so we've had the bread proven all night under the cling film. Now you can see, should we just show Granny Gramsci? So you can see it's nicely proved up, okay? So it's fully proved, it's nice and soft, it's got all the air bubbles there. And what you want to do is just stand back a little bit so they can see. What you want to do is maybe just go around and just pull the bread gently from the side and make sure it's not stuck, because that's the next problem if it sticks, isn't it? It might rip and then you lose all the air bubbles, don't you? Yeah. So what we're going to do is probably best if we move the camera down to where the oven is so you can see it coming in the oven, and then we can go from there. Right. So is that going to be okay there, Innis? There we go. So what we've done is, if you stand there, because if you go down to my tree and see the camera, because you're going to have to talk what we're going through. So in here, we've had the oven on at 240, okay? We've got our baking stone or our pizza stone. And yeah, you want the oven really nice and high. to start with, 240, and then for about 5 minutes, 8 minutes, and then we'll drop it down to 200 to finish cooking. So, put the bread, you get it round, dunk it on top, the little lucky tap. Bigger tap. And there we go. Just a little bit sticky, but it's come out. And then what I like to do is a nice sharp knife.
A nice sharp knife.
And then we just make a nice little incision. And that just helps give it a nice crust. Okay, just opens it up. And then, perfect. Push that in. What's good to do as well, if you've got a little water spray bottle, you just give the whole thing a little spray of water, and that just helps give it a nice crust. And that's it, really. So that'll go in until it's baked. How long is it taking us? We don't know. So we'll keep it on 100, we'll keep it on 240 for about 5-6 minutes, and then we'll turn it down to 200. Probably take about 15-ish minutes. So what's that? 20 to 11. So we'll come back after it's done.
The bread's ready, and now we're going to take it out of the oven.
Yeah, perfect. Right. Yep. Yeah. So the bread was in 240 degrees for about 6-7 minutes, and then we dropped it down to 200 for 20 minutes. And it's ready to come out now. So let me grab the camera, Innis, and we'll get this done. Right, so Innis, you're going to take it out of the oven. So there's the bread. On you go, Innis. That's it. That's it. And then lift it out. Go right to the back. No, no, you're okay. Right to the back. There you go. And you lift it out and then put it on the rack. Oh, look at that. Awesome bread. Whoop. And there she goes. So, that, what do you make of that, Innis?
Good.
Looks good, does it?
Yeah.
How does it smell?
Nice.
It's nice, it smells amazing, doesn't it? So, there you go, that's for bread. And what else do you want to say to the video?
Bye-bye, and I hope to get Easter eggs this Easter.
You hope you get Easter eggs this Easter. Have you had any Easter eggs?
Yes.
Yes, how many? Oh my gosh. Okay.
Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this.